Heredity, genes and behavior, that is our topic for today. We inherit characteristics from our parents in the form of genes. The study of the inheritance of physical and psychological characteristics from ancestors is referred to as genetics. So the study about this these genes is known as genetics, of course. And the child begins life as a single zygote cell, mother's ovum fertilized by father's sperm. Zygote is a tiny cell with a nucleus in its center containing chromosomes. These chromosomes with all genes are inherited from each parent in equal numbers. So our human body, usually all the cells have the nucleus, and inside the nucleus we have the chromosomes, and inside the chromosomes we have the DNA, and the DNA has a gene. See the picture. Inside a cell, we have a nucleus. When we zoom in, we can see the nucleus. Inside the nucleus, we have the chromosomes. Chromosomes are the thread-like structures that carry our genes. And inside the chromosome, when we zoom in, we can see the DNA. DNA is a helical structure. And inside the DNA, again, when we zoom in, we have the gene. And these genes are responsible for certain specific characteristics of our body. Like it is passed on from the father as well as the mother to the child. And when the reproductive cells of the father and the mother fuses together, the fusion forms the zygote. Okay, that tiny cell that is formed after the fertilization of the ovum as well as the sperm is known as the zygote. And we move on to the chromosomes. Chromosomes, I already told you, they are the thread-like structures in the nucleus, and they carry the hereditary elements. Whatever hereditary elements that we are getting from our father and mother, this is carried by the chromosomes in the nucleus. The gametic cells, I already told you, the gametes, that is the male gamete is called the sperm and the female gamete is the ovum. They have 23 chromosomes, but not in pairs. A new generation results from the fusion of a sperm cell as an egg cell, and together when they fuse, it is known as the zygote, which we already told. Chromosomes are composed mainly of a substance called deoxyribonucleic acid, that is the DNA that we commonly call DNA. Our genes are composed chiefly of DNA molecules. Now here, in human body, usually the chromosomes occur in pairs, but the gamete cells or the reproductive cells, they don't occur in pairs. Instead, they occur in a different manner. They have 23 chromosomes in them. But in total, the human body cells have 23 pairs, that is 23 into 2, 46 chromosomes, except the gamete cells, that is the sperm and the ovum. Now, these are the chromosomes. Yes. At the time of conception, the organism inherits 46 chromosomes from parents, 46 chromosomes from parents, 23 from the mother, and 23 from the father. So, I already told you the gametes fuse to form the zygote. So gametes don't have pairs, instead they have 23 and 23. So when 23 comes from the father and 23 comes from the mother, it fuses to form 23 pairs, that is total of 46 chromosomes in the baby. Okay, each of these chromosomes contains thousands of genes. However, the sperm cell differs from the egg cell in one important respect, that is, the 23rd chromosome of the sperm cell can be either the capital X or Y type of the English alphabet. If the X type sperm fertilizes the egg cell, the fertilized egg will have an XX 23rd chromosome pair and the child will be a female. And on the other hand, if a Y type sperm fertilizes the egg, the 23rd chromosome pair will be XY and the child will be a male. So I already told you the gamete cells, they don't have pairs. Instead, they have 23 chromosomes. But in males, it is of XY type. And in females, it is of XX type. So consider it like this. You have two baskets and from that you're taking and trying to fuse these cells. And in one basket, you have the last one as XY. And in the other basket, you have XX, only XX types. So you draw each one eggs from this, one eggs from this, and you try and fuse it. And once you get one eggs from the one basket and the other eggs from the other basket, then you get a combination of XX. So XX means it forms a female zygote. And if you take a Y from the male basket, and if you take an X, the female basket only has X chromosomes, right? So if you take the X chromosome and Y chromosome from the male basket and fuse it together, then you get a zygote of XY type. The XY type always indicates the male form. So the baby will become a male or a boy. That's how the fusion takes place regarding the XY and the XX type chromosomes. Then we have a small topic on genes. Every chromosome stores thousands of genetic commands in the form of genes. They contain instructions for the production of specific proteins which regulate the body's physiological processes and the expression of phenotypic traits. Now we have two terms to note here, that is phenotype as well as genotype. Phenotype means the observable traits of an organism, and they're like the physical strength, the hair color, the eye color, color of the pupil, the texture of your hair, your body build, all that comes under the phenotype. Now what is genotype? All the genetic material that is passed on from your parents or from your ancestors to you, to the offspring, is known as the genotype. All biological and psychological characteristics that a modern man possesses are the result of genotype inheritance with phenotypical variations. So we as in heredity or as hereditary, we get so many things from our ancestors, but not everything is expressed in our physical characteristics. There we will have some inherited genes for some, for example, you get your father has black hair and your mother has blonde hair. And you will get the genes for both of these. But what is expressed in you? That is, if you get black hair, if you grow black hair, then that is the phenotype which others can observe. The observable characteristic that you have is black hair. So black hair will be your phenotype. But inside, when you analyze the genetic material, you can see that you have the genes for both blonde hair as well as black hair. Then that is your genotype. Understood? The physical characteristics is related to phenotype, the fur. Remember it like that. And the genetic material that you have is related to genotype. Understood? Yes? Yes or no? Yes, okay. Then what? Yeah, all biological and psychological characteristics that a modern man possesses are the result of genotype inheritance with phenotypical variations. So the combinations of phenotype and genotype results in the different or unique psychological as well as the physical characteristics that we have. Now the next thing is about mutation. A given gene can exist in several different forms. Change of a gene from one form to another is called mutation. The type of mutation that occurs spontaneously in nature provides variation in genotypes and permits the evolution of new species. So the changes that occur in a gene, in a particular gene, is termed as mutation. I hope you are familiar with the term mutation. Most of the films in scientific fictions and all, you hear about mutations. Mutations means we have a chemical composition for our DNA and our genes. For each person, it is unique in nature. And when these combinations are changed in some or the other manner, because of some genetic or biological reason, then that form is known as, or the changed form is known as the mutated one. Or that process is known as the mutation. Understood? Yes, so that's all about our biological basis. So any doubts in this? Any doubts in the topic? No? Shall we proceed with the revision then?
Ma'am, can you tell first onwards?
Which one?
Ma'am, I joined late because there was network problem.
Okay, just a minute. Yeah, we talked about the heredity, genes and behavior. This is our last topic in the biological basis. And this picture explains the whole of the topic. When we have a cell, inside that we have the nucleus. And when we zoom in, we can see the nucleus. Inside that we have the chromosomes, the thread-like structures or the ribbon-like structures. They form the chromosomes. And even when we go deep into it, we can see the DNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid. And these DNA contain the genes. This is the basic thing that we are studying. And when we saw the more of the topic chromosomes, we told that the gametes, all the cells in the human body, they have 23 pairs of chromosomes. But in gametic cells, that are the reproductive cells, which are they? The male body, it is sperm, and the female body, it is ovum. They only have 23 chromosomes, not in pairs. And when a zygote is formed by the fusion of the sperm and ovum, it will receive 23 from the mother as well as 23 from the father. So finally, it will have 46 chromosomes. Like any other human body, it will finally have 46 chromosomes. And yeah, it already told about DNA. Then, yeah, these you saw, right, Meghna? From here onwards?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so that's it. Okay, now the revision. Shall we start then? What happened to you, Meghna? Are you not well?
It's allergy, ma'am.
Allergy, okay. Taking medications for that?
No.
No. Okay, then first question Ashish will be asking to you. Yes, Ashish? And Meghna and Grishma, Sana and all, Grishma was there. Meghna and Sana, what we are doing is, you will be asking questions to the group or to a specific person. And who knows the answer, who all knows the answer, put their hands up. And the person who answers correctly will get the chance to ask the next question. Okay? Okay. So Ashish is going to ask first. Come on.
Give and you give fine. An example for
powder, please.
Give an example for mind and body are not connected.
Mind and body are not connected. Explain with an example. Yeah, carry on, Aishwarya.
Is it the Dweck study?
Is it the Dweck study, Ashish?
Yes.
Is it the Dweck study?
Yes.
Okay. Why? What was your answer? You had something else in mind, right?
Nothing.
Nothing. It's the same answer that you thought about?
Yes.
Okay, then carry on, Aishwarya.
Definition of psychology.
Who knows the definition of psychology? Meghna, okay, tell.
Psychology is formally defined as a science which studies the mental process, experience and behavior in different contexts.
Correct, Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
Definition of psychology, it is a sure question. Then the William Wundt, the Leipzig, the 1879 thing, that is the sure question in any of the exams that you'll attend in psychology. Then, yeah, okay. Now, Meghna, you can ask.
Who is known as the father of experimental psychology?
Who knows the answer? Except Aishwarya, who knows the answer? Hamal and Ashish, why are you sitting here, man? Don't you know? None of you knows. Oh my God. Do you know, Ashish? Was that you putting your hands up? I can't understand. Is it? Yes, Krishma, just a minute. Ashish is stuck. Amal, do you know the answer?
Amelia Mood.
Why didn't you put your hands up then? Yes, Grishma, what was your answer?
Same, William Mood.
Is it correct, Meghna?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very good, Amal and Grishma. Then who would ask next? Amal, you ask the next question.
And application of education psychology. Hello, use.
What application?
And use of education psychology.
Use of educational psychology. Yes. Educational psychology. Yes, Aishwarya. Yes.
It is used to motivate children.
Then.
Helps them with to control their emotions and.
Then, what does an educational psychologist do in an educational setting?
They can help in administering and.
Yes, administering test.
They can also interpret the test.
Interpret the test.
They can help in the school affairs.
School affairs, in developing policies, in changing the different methods that the teachers teach in. They can also conduct trainings for the teachers. Okay. Yes. Amal, correct answer? Yes. Then I show you next question.
What are the two types of behavior?
Two types of behaviors. Who knows the answer? That is also an yet another important question. Note that. Two types of behavior. Sana, do you know?
Overt and covert.
Overt and covert. Is that correct, Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sana, you ask the next question. You can ask one word questions or. Yeah, come on.
What are mental processes?
What are mental processes? What are mental processes? Yes, tell.
Those are the activities of the mind and the brain.
Is that correct? Okay.
Yes.
Question. I show you.
Which two forms of science also borrow principles from psychology?
Meghna.
Computer science and neuroscience.
Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Next question.
How does the social and cultural psychology affect our lives?
How does social and cultural psychology affect our lives? I want the boys to answer. They are sitting as if they have come for a party or something. Chilling out there. Ash is stuck again. Amal, you are left out. Ashish is stuck. You'll have to answer this. Meghna, can you repeat the question?
How does social and cultural psychology affect our lives?
Biting his nail. Do you know the answer, Amal?
This studies about the attitude.
Attitude? It studies attitude then?
And behave, helping my impressions, behaviors, aggressions, and the social motivations.
Okay, then?
And
right?
Is that a satisfying answer, Meghna?
I think some more is there.
Okay, you. Thank you, Amal. You can explain the rest of the question.
The cultural psychology, it's a traditions, culture, beliefs, etc. The social psychology, it's the particular individual where resides in the society and the environment.
Okay, fine. Now I'll ask you questions. Who gave, we'll have a kind of rapid fire. Okay? Okay. Who gave the equation B equal to F of PE? Oh, yo, don't sit as if you're hearing for the first time. Yes, Meghna.
Kurt Lewin.
Kurt Lewin, very good. Then. Where was the first psychology laboratory established in the world?
Leipzig, Germany.
Okay. Which year?
1879.
Okay. Okay. Psychology is a hybrid science because of two branches. Which are they?
Social and science.
Social science and? Yes, Krishma?
Science.
Natural science.
Natural science. Okay. Then, which chapter are we studying? First chapter, right? Yes. Which branch of psychology studies the enhancement of motivation of sports people?
Sports psychology.
Oh, it goes. Now the questions are exclusively for boys, okay? Girls, please keep quiet. Okay, which expression? Which branch of psychology deals with the industrial context or the work settings?
Organizational
or industrial psychology. Okay, and clinical psychology or counseling psychology, which deals with more serious problems?
Clinical psychology.
Clinical, sure. Ashish thinks counseling, right?
Clinical.
Satyam. Thank
you. Promise.
Okay, promise.
Satyam.
Okay, fine. Correct answer. Now, how is computer science and psychology related? For the boys. You haven't unmuted, Amal.
It's like storing in the brain.
Yeah. What does that compared with in computer science?
It's a computer.
The computer. And for example, like a memory storage. Okay. Yes. Then, what is the equation that Kurt Lewin gave?
Question answer.
Keep your mic towards your mouth. Okay, now tell me.
Question once more.
Okay. Which is the equation that Kurt Lewin gave?
P equal to F.
Equal to F into
P.
B, P, E, F, what is it?
Ma'am, P equal to F.
D is equal to P. F into P into E.
P, yeah. Wait, just a minute, Amal. Ashish is telling something. Yes, tell me. Ashish went. Okay, Amal, continue. Ashish is gone.
Ma'am, P equal to F of P. Hello, F of?
F of? Don't eat your headset, you tell me. Yeah. F of?
Forgot.
Okay. Behavior is a function of person and the environment. So put that into the equation. Behavior is. So B equal to. Yes, Ashish is back. Come on, Ashish. Ah, come on.
I put it in the chat box.
Oh, chat box. Precious chat box. B equal to F of P. Very good. Did you go to refer textbook just now? Okay. Okay. The next, learn that formula thoroughly. Okay, that's very important. Amal, don't confuse it. You read that theme that we have studied regarding Kurt Lewin's thing and connect it with the equation and study. Or otherwise, it will be like Thare's Amoeba. The F will fly away, the B will come this way, and the comma will be in between, and the equation would go to some other place. I don't know where. Okay, then what is the basic difference between basic and applied psychology? You are still turning your book. I can see that, Amal. I'll catch you one day. Your first exam is psychology, right? Ah, very good. Okay, Aishwarya, tell me.
Basic psychology deals with the hypothesis. First, we have to create the hypothesis, and in the applied psychology, we apply the hypothesis to get the solution.
Okay, so in basic psychology, we deal with the theories and principles. But in applied psychology, we apply or we put these into practice, these theories and principles. Okay, that's a basic difference. Then, give an example of covert and overt behavior. Ashish, you know? Sana, do you know?
Laughing.
Laughing is the what behavior?
Overt
behavior. Okay, thank you. Next answer. Anybody? Except Aishwarya.
Writing.
Writing, what behavior?
Covert.
Overt, okay. Any covert behaviors?
Imagining of his or her future.
Okay. Then, Grishma, what did you tell?
Feeling hungry.
Feeling hungry. Okay. Good. Then, what do we have? Yeah, which are the themes in psychology? Studied
research and application.
What? Research and application. Yeah.
Research and application.
Oh, we had five themes in that.
First theme, psychology, like other sciences, attempt to develop a principle of behavior and mental process.
Okay, then.
Human behavior is a function of attributes of person and environment.
Yeah, that is the B equal to F of PE. Then?
Then, human behavior is constructed.
Cost. human behavior is cost. That is the next thing.
Understanding of human behavior is culturally constructed.
Then,
human behavior can be controlled and modified through application of psychological principles.
Okay. Then, what is introspection? Anybody? Yes.
It is a method in which the person tells in detail about the experience. Of the person itself.
Okay. And which school of psychology used introspection as a method of study?
Structuralism.
Structure, correct. Then William James belonged to which school of psychology?
Functionalism.
Then who are the proponents of gestalt psychology?
One person is Abraham. Someone.
Abraham Maslow. Is it?
Kurt Kofler.
Kurt Kofka. Abraham Maslow is humanistic, not just a. Kurt Kofka, then?
Max Wertheimer.
Wertheimer. These names are very important. Schools of psychology and the proponents are very important. You have to study that by heart, okay? He'll come for the exam. Max Wertheimer, Kurt Kofka. Yes. Okay, then psychoanalysis was found by which person?
Sigmund Freud.
What is the spelling of Sigmund Freud again?
Sigmund Freud.
You were the same person who told in last class, right?
I should have told.
Okay. Then what else do we have? Yeah, humanistic perspective. What does it focus on? When you hear humanistic, you have to think about humans. They're something, something.
Personal growth.
Yeah, their will, their personal will, the power of their own will, the power to reach their own potential, and considering humans as completely positive. All those things are focused in humanistic perspective. Then, Ashish, which are the schools of psychology? Schools of psychology. Means in the evolution, which all did we study about? Starting with structuralism. Stuck. Amal, do you know? Structuralism? No. Study that. That's very important topic. That's the first thing that we studied, I think. No, not the first thing, but still. Yes. In any schools of psychology, you know, that you know? Amal, just a minute, Aishwarya. I told structuralism. Then anything else that you know? In the schools? No. Unmute. Yes, tell me. Gestalt psychology, humanistic. Aishwarya, complete the rest.
Humanistic perspective, cognitive psychology, psychoanalytic, then behaviorism,
functionalism. Okay, fine. Okay, we'll continue. Plus, tomorrow's a holiday, but I'll give you some revision questions. Just try and find answers for them. Okay. Yes, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.